हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज शांति शिरसाट फ्रॉम इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ प्रवीण पाटिल पॉलिटेक्निक भाईंदर। इन दिस सेशन वी लर्न अबाउट नेटवर्क कंपोनेंट्स एंड टोपोलॉजीज। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ टॉपिक लर्निंग आउटकम्स, कोएक्सियल केबल एंड फाइबर ऑप्टिक केबल्स। फिजिकल डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ द कोएक्सियल केबल। This is a coaxial cable having outer conductor, then wire insulation, foil shield, braided sheet and cable jacket. Here the data is transmitted through the conductor and other things are used for coating. Central conductor. At the heart of the coaxial cable is a central conductor, typically constructed of either pure copper or copper coated steel or dielectric medium aluminium. The conductor is responsible for transmitting the cable's signal. Dielectric insulator. Its purpose is twofold. First, it acts as an insulator between the center conductor and outer braided foil sheet. Second, it helps physically hold the center conductor at the center of the cable. It is made of polyethylene, Teflon, polyethylene, polypropylene and polyvinyl chloride. That is PVC plastic, okay, PVC. Braided sheet. Interference tends to come in two different flavors. One is electromagnetic interference and another one is radiomagnetic interference. Electromagnetic interference is often caused by heavy power lines, cell phone signals, etc. A braided shield protects the signal from EMI interference, which often range from 30% to 94%. Coverage. The higher the coverage, the better the protection, and this is the responsibility of braided sheet. Next is the foil shield. Although not always present on coaxial cable, the foil shield serves to protect from the RFI interference, that is radio frequency interference. Foil shields are almost always made out of aluminium foil and simply around the inner parts of the cable. Unlike a braided shield, which have a percent coverage, two shields always cover 100%. The outer jacket is generally made out of the flammable, that is PVC polyvinyl chloride, and serves primarily to hold the cable together and protect it from the elements. Next, what are the characteristics of coaxial cable? It transmits both analog and digital signal, having superior frequency characteristics compared to the twisted pair cable. It can support the high frequency and data rates. It requires the amplifiers after every few kilometers for long distance transmission. Usable spectrum for analog signaling up to 500 megahertz. Requires the repeaters every few kilometers for digital transmission also. For both analog and digital transmission, closer spacing is necessary for higher frequency or data rates. What are the applications of coaxial cable used in telephone networks? Other than that, in digital telephone network, where the single coaxial cable could carry digital data up to Mbps, most commonly used in cable TV. Coaxial cabling is often used in heavy industrial environments. Another common application of coaxial cable is traditionally Ethernet LAN. What are the advantages of coaxial cable? Low cost due to the less total footage of cable. Hubs not needed. Low attenuation than twisted pair cable. Good immunity to electromagnetic interference using braided shield. Supports high bandwidth. Disadvantages of coaxial cable. limited in network speed, limited in size of network. One bad connector can take down entire network. Coaxial cable can be bulky. It is among the most expensive type of wire cables. Next transmission media is a fiber optic cable. It is a glass cabling media that sends the network signals using the light. A fiber optic cable's light pipe, which is used to carry the light beam from one place to another place. Higher bandwidth capacity. It has an inner core of glass that conducts the light. Inner core is surrounded by cladding. This is a fiber optic cable construction. It contains the core, which is used to transmit the data, and it is made up of glass, then cladding to protect the core and keep the core at the center of the cable, then coating, then strengthening the fibers to protect the core from external forces, and after that the cable jacket. We learn in detail one by one, that is structure of the fiber optic cable. Construction of the fiber optic cable. One is a core. This is the physical medium that transport the optical data signal from an attached light source to the receiving device. The core is a single continuous strand of glass or plastic that's measured in microns by the size of its outer diameter. The larger the core, the more light can be carried. All fiber optic cable is sized according to its core's outer diameter. The three multimode size most commonly available are 50, 62.5 and 100 microns. Single mode cores are generally less than 9 microns. Next construction point is cladding. This is the thin layer that surrounds the fiber core and serves as a boundary that contains the light waves and causes the refraction. Means the light which is passes through the core refracted in the cladding, and that enabling the data travel throughout the length of the fiber segment. Next is a coating. This is layer of plastic that surrounds core and cladding and reinforce and protects the fiber core. Coating are measured in microns and can range from 250 to 900 microns. Next is strengthening fibers. These components help protect the core against the crushing forces and external forces and excessive tension during the installation. Last one is a cabling jacket. This is the outer layer of the fiber optic cable. Most fiber optic cables have an orange jacket, although sometimes can have a black or yellow jackets. What are the characteristics of fiber optic cables? Fiber optic cabling can provide extremely high bandwidth in the range from 100 Mbps to 2 gigabits because light has much higher frequency than electricity. The number of nodes which a fiber optic can support does not depend on its length but on the hub or hubs that connects the cable together. Fiber optic cable has much more attenuation and can carry the signal to the longer distance without using amplifiers and repeaters, which are used in twisted pair cable and fiber optic cable. It is not attached by EMI effects and can be used in areas where high voltage are passing by. The cost of the fiber optic cable is more compared to the other two cables. The installation of fiber optic cable is also difficult and tedious. What are the applications of fiber optic cable? One is in medical field, that is used as a light guides, imaging tools, and also as a laser for surgery. Defense or government, used as a hydrophones for seismic and sonar uses, as a wiring in aircraft, submarines and other vehicles, and also for field networking. data storage used for data transmission. Next is a telecommunications. Fiber is a laid and used for transmitting and receiving purposes. Next is a networking. Used to connect the users and servers in a variety of network settings and help increasing the speed and accuracy of data transmission. Broadcast or CAT TV. Broadcast or cable companies are using fiber optic cables for wiring CAT TV, HD TV, internet, video on demand and other applications. What are the advantages of fiber optic cable? High data rate than TP, that is twisted pair and coaxial cable. Less signal attenuation, noise resistance, lightweight and more immune to tapping, that is security. What are the disadvantages of fiber optic cable? Installation and maintenance needs expertise that is not yet available everywhere. Propagation of light is unidirectional. Fiber optic cable is more expensive. Limited physical arc of cable, which is the most important drawback of the fiber optic cable. Because what is meant by limited physical arc, that is the size of that core is depend on external area, that is outer area's arc. Or if the outer area's arc is limited, then the core is also of limited size of microns. Thank you.